So I am teaching random variables and stochastic processes. Before going to random variables and stochastic processes, first we know about the introduction to probability. Okay, first we know about the introduction to probability. If we know the probability concepts, then only we understand the random variables concept. Okay, ma'am. So in this. So why we are introducing the probability concept? Okay, ma'am. So why we are introducing the probability concept means here, if you are observing, we are having the signals, deterministic signals and non-deterministic signals. Okay, ma'am. Deterministic signals and non-deterministic signals. If you are taking deterministic signals, so if you are taking deterministic signals, a signal whose future values can be estimated with the help of a definite relationship or prescribed by a definite function is called a deterministic signal. Okay, ma? చూడండి ఇక్కడ. So a signal whose future values can be estimated with the help of a definite relationship or described by a definite function is called a deterministic signal. That means here the name itself says deterministic. Okay, the name itself says deterministic. చూడండి ఇక్కడ ఏంటి, future values can be estimated with the help of a definite relationship. That means based on the relationship we can estimate the future values, then those signals are called deterministic signals. Okay, a signal whose future values can be estimated with the help of a definite relationship or described by a definite function is called a deterministic signal. Here there is no uncertainty in predicting the future values of the signal. Here predicting means, what is meant by general meaning for the prediction? Imagination. That means here in this deterministic signal there is no uncertainty in predicting the future values of the signal. That means, so here there is no need to imagine the future values. Okay, ma? Future values ni manam imagine chesukovalsina necessity ledu. Indulo exactly we are finding the exact value, we are determining the signal value. Ela determine chestunnam ani cheptunnamu, definite relationship ni or described by a definite function ni use chesukoni manam future values ni describe cheyachu, determine cheyachu. That will be the deterministic signals, amma. Okay, na? If you are taking examples, mathematical functions, periodic signals, like this. Suppose if you are taking, suppose y equal to 2x plus 3. Okay, so this is a mathematical function. Here, suppose if you are taking x value, x equal to 0. Then what is the y value? Y equal to 2 into 0 plus 3. That means y equal to 3. Exactly we determine y value. Okay. Suppose if you are taking x equal to 1. Then y equal to 2 into 1 plus 3. That means 5. So y equal to 5. At x equal to 10. Y equal to 2 into 10 plus 3. That means 23. Okay. At x equal to 50, at x equal to 50, 2 into 50 plus 3. That means 100 plus 3, 103. Y equal to 103. So by observing, based on this mathematical relationship or function, we determine the future values. Here we are no uncertainty in predicting future values of the signal. That means here there is no confusion about the future values. ఓకే అమ్మా. సో మనం ఫ్యూచర్ వాల్యూస్ ని ఎగ్జాక్ట్ గా డిటర్మైన్ చేయొచ్చు. అట్ డిఫరెంట్ వాల్యూస్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ వి ఆర్ గెటింగ్ వై వాల్యూ. exactly we are getting y value. So this is the deterministic signal. Okay, in deterministic signal, the name itself says, and determine cheyagalamu ela cheyagalam based on the relationship or mathematical functions. Okay, suppose this is mathematical functions. Next, periodic signals. What is meant by periodic signals? Suppose if you are taking sine wave, cosine wave, those will be periodic signals. Okay, so here suppose y equal to sine theta is there. Y equal to sine theta at theta equal to 0 degrees. What is y value? Sine zero. That is zero. At theta equal to 90 degrees. What is y value? Sine 90 degrees. That is 1. And based on some relationship or based on some function, we are determining the exact value for that signal. So that's why this is deterministic signal. Okay, ma? This is deterministic signal. Here, no need to predicting. And then, manam predict cheyalsina avasaram indulo emi undadu. Kachitanga, we are getting exact value for that signal. Okay, ma. So this is the deterministic signal. Next, non-deterministic signals. See here, non-deterministic signals. That means we are not determining. The name itself says. So here, if you observe the definition. A signal whose future values cannot be predicted is called a non-deterministic signal. Ante enti ikkada the signal whose future values cannot be predicted. Ante future values ni manam predict cheyalekapothe that will be the non-deterministic signal. Okay, there is no definite function or relationship to describe the generation of such signals. That means here in non-deterministic signals there is no definite function. You are not saying this is a function for non-deterministic signal like that. Okay, no definite function or relationship to describe the generation of non-deterministic signals. Okay, ma, the signal values vary randomly with the time or frequency. The signal values vary randomly with the time or frequency. Okay, ma. So here, randomly. What is meant by randomly? What is meant by randomly here? So the signal values vary randomly. That means in zigzag manner, whether increasing or decreasing, we don't know. Okay. So vary randomly with the time or frequency. So that is a non-deterministic signal. There is an uncertainty in predicting the future values of these signals. Okay, there is an uncertainty. That means here in determining these non-deterministic signals, we are having some confusion. What is the value? What is the signal value we'll be getting? That is not be predicting here. Okay, so if you are taking the example, that will be noise signals. Okay, already we know noise means, that means unwanted signal that will always be random. Okay, always be random. For noise, we are not taking any relationship or any definite function here. We are not predicting this noise also. Okay, so this noise signal is a example for non-deterministic signals. So here in this non-deterministic signals, so there is an uncertainty in predicting the future values of these signals. That means, so here we are having some confusion. And we are not predicting, we are not imagining the future value is that. So at this non-deterministic signals, we are using the concept of probability. Okay, ma? So in non-deterministic signals, lo manam probability ane concept ni introduce chesam. Probability ane concept ni enduku introduce chesamu ante, in this we are not predicting the future values. That means the values, the signal values are changes randomly. The signal values changes randomly. So to determine the non-deterministic signals, we are introducing the concept of probability. General meaning for probability means that will be may or may not be occurred. May or may not be occurred. if you are having in your intermediate also probability concept will be there. In that we are taking examples that will be, if you are taking the experiment tossing a coin, okay, tossing a coin, what are the outcomes will be getting for tossing a coin? Head and tails. Okay, so for before doing the experiment, are you say exactly head is coming or exactly tail is coming? Before doing the experiment, we can't say exactly. So that means in that cases we are using the concept of probability. Okay, suppose if you are taking another experiment, rolling a die. If you are doing the experiment rolling a die, then what are the outcomes will be getting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so the outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So before doing that rolling a die experiment, are you say exactly 3 is coming or 5 is coming or 6 is coming? You are not predicting that value randomly, either coming 1 or 3 or 6 or 2 like that. Okay, randomly that outcome will be getting. We can't predicting the future values here. So these are the examples for probability concept. Okay, so if you are taking the probability definition, probability is a type of ratio when we compare how many times an outcome can occur compared to all possible outcomes. Okay ma, so here general definition for the probability is equal to the number of wanted outcomes, wanted in the sense favorable outcomes, the number of favorable outcomes divided by the number of total outcomes. Okay, the number of wanted means favorable, wanted in the sense favorable, divided by the number of possible means total outcomes. Okay ma, so the definition for the probability, the definition for the probability is the ratio of the number of favorable outcomes to the number of total outcomes. Okay ma, this is the definition of the probability. Okay, so here suppose here if you are taking probability of A, suppose if you are taking A event will be there, for that A event we determine the probability P of A equal to, okay, suppose the number of favorable outcomes is n and the number of total outcomes are m like that. So if we are not, if we want the probability of complement of A, then how to find out the probability of complement of A? Means here, see here, the probability of non-occurrence of the event A is called the probability of failure of occurrence. Okay, non-occurrence of the event, non-occurrence of the event in the sense failure of the occurrence. Okay, that will be P of A complement. P of A complement, that is A complement is also written as not A, not A. Okay, the number of favorable outcomes, here number of favorable outcomes are n minus m. Okay, number of favorable outcomes, here P of A complement will be taking, P of A complement will be taking non-occurrence, non-occurrence. That's why here we are getting n minus m divided by the total number of possible outcomes are n. Okay ma, so here if you are this denominator is applicable for n and m. Okay, so if you are separating this n by n minus m by n, n by n means numerator and denominator are equal, that's why 1 minus m by n, that means m by n in the sense here this is favorable divided by total, so that is nothing but probability of A. Okay, probability of A, here in this step we understand the probability of non-occurrence of A is equal to 1 minus the probability of occurrence of A. Okay, probability of non-occurrence of A is equal to 1 minus probability of occurrence of A. Okay, why? Because here we are getting, so if you are taking next year, in next year, next we are saying the sum of all probabilities is 1 here. Okay, the sum of all probabilities is 1, that will be coming next time. So here, see here, for an event A, the probability will lie between 0 and 1. Okay, remember this point. Always the probability is in between 0 and 1. That means the minimum value is 0 and the maximum value is 1 only. Okay, so always the probability is in between 0 and 1. Okay, next, the sum of probabilities in a given experiment is always 1. Okay, suppose if you in any experiment, if you are getting number of outcomes, the probability of getting all the outcomes, the sum of probabilities of all the outcomes is equal to 1. Okay, the sum of probabilities in a given experiment is always 1. And ikkada entamma, suppose manu oka experiment chesinappudu maniki number of outcomes ostayi kada, so each outcome ki manu probability find out chestam. Ela find out chestamu? Number of favorable outcomes divided by number of total outcomes. Ee formula use chesukoni manam prati outcome ki, each and every outcome ki manam probability find out chestam. If you are taking the sum of all probabilities, that value is always 1. That value is always 1. Okay, ma? That value is always 1 here. Next, see here. Here, experiment means a repeatable procedure. That means whether we are doing tossing a coin or rolling a die. Suppose if you are getting some box will be there. In that box, 2 white balls, 3 red balls, like that. So whatever the experiment we are doing, that will be a repeatable procedure here. Okay. So suppose if you are taking the tossing a coin, so tossing a coin 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, like that. So that will be a repeatable procedure.
My voice cut out, ma'am.
Ma, voice cut out, na. Vinpadatle na?
Disturbance ga undi.
Nenu konji getti cheppanu, ma'am.
Mute lo pettanu andarni. ఒక్క నిమిషమా
మీ వాయిస్ క్లారిటీ లేదు మ్యామ్
ఓకే
మధ్య మధ్య
So here experiment. Experiment means this is a repeatable procedure. That means depending on our requirement, we are doing the experiment number of times. Okay. Next, sample space. What is meant by a sample space here? Set of all possible outcomes. Set of all possible outcomes. So if you are taking any experiment, in that experiment, if you are taking the set of all possible outcomes, then that will be the sample space S. Okay, that will be the sample space S. Yeah. Next, event. Event. What is meant by an event here? A subset of the sample space. A subset of the sample space is called an event. Okay, ma, sample space and ante. Suppose if you are taking any experiment, in that experiment, if you consider all the possible outcomes, then that will be called as a sample space. Okay, ma, event. Event means, so this is a subset of sample space. Here only we are considering only some of the outcomes. Only konni outcomes manam consider chestunnamo anukunnama. That will be called as an event. Okay. So probability function gives the probability for each outcome. That means here, suppose event will be taking as W. That W is belongs to sample space. Okay, that W is belongs to sample space. That means the event belongs to sample space. Okay, ma. So here always already we know this probability is between 0 and 1. That means probability minimum value is 0 and the maximum value is 1. Okay, ma? Total probability of all possible outcomes is 1. Okay, no? So these are the definitions for probability. So here, suppose if you are taking one example, that will be experiment is taking as a tossing a coin. Okay, whenever we are doing this experiment tossing a coin, what are the outcomes we'll be getting? Head and tail. Okay, ma? Head and tail. So the sample space S is equal to head comma tail here. Okay, ma? So the probability function means here if you are taking probability for getting head, probability for getting head. How we know this probability for getting head? What is the formula for the probability? Number of favorable outcomes divided by number of possible outcomes. So based on this formula, here probability of getting head is equal to number of favorable outcomes. Here how many heads are there? Only one head. So one divided by total possible outcomes. Total possible outcomes ennu nayamma? Two unnai. Kabatti one divided by two. What is the value? 0.5. Okay. Probability for getting head is equal to 0.5. Okay, ma? Next, probability for getting tail. Probability for getting tail. So here also we are using the definition. So that will be number of favorable outcomes divided by the number of total outcomes. So in the sample space lo favorable ennu unnai, tails ennu unnai. Only one tail will be there. So one divided by the total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes means here, how many total number of outcomes? Two. That means one divided by two. That is equal to 0.5. Okay, ma? That is equal to 0.5. So this is a, in this way we are taking probability for getting head and probability for getting tail. Okay. So here the outcomes are head and tail. Suppose if this will be right in a table. So table lo raste. So that will be outcomes are head and tail. Probability for getting head 1 divided by 2. So probability for getting tail 1 by 2. Okay. In this way we are calculating the probability. So in this we know about some definitions in set theory also. Set theory. Okay, ma. So generally, what is meant by a set? Set. That means a set is any collection of objects specified in such a way that we can determine whether a given object is or is not in the collection. Okay, ma. Generally, set means that is a collection of objects. Okay, collection of objects is called a set. Okay, in other words, a set is a collection of objects here. These objects are called, so objects manam em antam, these objects are called elements or members of the set. Okay, ma? Suppose if you are taking any set will be there. Suppose if you are taking A equal to 1, 3, 4, 7, 9. So this is a set. That means this is a collection of objects. So each object is called an element or a members of the set. Okay. So this set having totally 5 elements. In this way, the set will be represented. Next, empty set or null set. Empty set or null set means here an empty set is a set which has no members. That means which has no elements. So maniki set lo number of elements em levu anukunnamma, then that will be called as an empty set, or that will also called as null set. Okay, that representation symbol is 5. The null set representation symbol is 5. Okay, so this is a null set. Next, equal set. Equal set. The name itself says equal. Equal means two sets are equal if they both have the same members. That means if they both have the same elements. Two sets are having same elements, then those two sets are called equal set. Okay. So if you are taking A equal to 1, 2, 3, the elements are 1, 2, 3. B equal to 1, 2, 3. So B is having elements 1, 2, 3. If you observe these two sets having the equal elements. Okay. Equal, same elements will be there. That's why then A equal to B. Okay. So this is one equal set. Suppose the order is need not be necessary here. Only we are observing the elements. Okay. So see here. C equal to 1, 2, 5. D equal to 5, 1, 2. Whatever the order, but the elements will be same. So these type of sets are called equal set. Okay. These type of sets are called equal set. Next, subsets. What is meant by subset? A set A is a subset of a set B. If all the elements of A are contained in members of the larger set B. Okay. So, A subset B. A subset B and eppudu antamo antama. If all the elements in A are included in set B. Okay. All the elements in A are included in set B. A lo unna elements anni B lo kuda unte, then we are saying A is subset of B. Suppose if you are taking example, A is equal to 137. B equal to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9. So here these are the two sets. A is equal to 137, B equal to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9. Okay, ma. So if we observe these two sets, so the elements in A, 1, 3, 7, are also present in set B also, 1, 3, 7. Okay. So here we are saying A is subset of B. Okay, ma. A is subset of B. So this is the meaning for subset. Here, set A is a subset of B if and only if. A, every element of A is also an element of B. Here, 1, 3, 7. These are the elements in A. So, each element will be present in B also. Okay, 1 is present, 3 is present, 7 is present. Okay, so this is a subset. Okay, the notation is taking as like this. Okay, A is subset B. To indicate that A is a subset of B. This is the notation we are using for subset. Okay. So disjoint sets. Disjoint sets. This disjoint sets means here. If we are taking two sets. When those two sets are called disjoint means. If they have no elements in common, and then two sets tisukunappudu aa two sets lo common elements emi levu anukundamma, no common elements, then those two sets are called disjoint sets. Okay, ma. So then those two sets are called disjoint sets. Suppose here we are taking one example, set S is equal to 2, 4, 6, 8 and T equal to 1, 3, 5, 7. If we observe these two sets, there is no common elements here between the two sets. Okay. So there is no common elements. So these two sets are called disjoint sets. Okay. These two sets are called disjoint sets. If the two sets having no common elements, then those are called disjoint sets. Next, union of sets. Union of sets. So, how you are representing union? combining all the elements of any two sets is called the union of those sets. Okay, ma? Combining all the elements of any two sets is called the union of those sets. Okay, so when we two sets తీసుకొని వాటిని కంబైన్ చేసామో అనుకుందామా, then that will be union of sets. Okay, union of two sets A and B is obtained by combining all the members of the sets and is represented as A union B. This is the symbol for union. Okay, this is the symbol for union. Okay, ma. So here taking one example, A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and B equal to 2, 4, 6, and B equal to 2, 4, 6. Then the union of these sets is called A union B. What is union? Combining all the elements in the two sets. 1, 2, 3 will be there. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means here union of sets means by combining all the elements in the two sets. That will be called as union of sets. Okay, ma. So this is a Venn diagram. This will be called as Venn diagram. Based on the elements in the set, we draw this Venn diagram. What is A elements? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B elements are 2, 4, 6. So 2, 4, 6. A union B means we are combining all the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is a Venn diagram for union, A union B, combining all the elements. Next, intersection of sets. Intersection in the sense that will be defined as the grouping up of the common elements of two or more sets. Okay, ma? If you are taking two sets, what are the common elements in the two sets? What are the common elements in the two sets? That common elements set is called intersection of sets. Intersection of sets. It is denoted by symbol. This is the symbol for intersection. Okay, ma? This is the symbol for intersection. Okay, example will be taking here. When set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 7, 11, 13 and set B equal to 1, 4, 7, 10, 13, 17. So observe these two sets. One is present in A and B. Two is not the common element. 3, not the common element. 7 will be present in A and B also. 11, not having. 13, both are having. So what are the elements in A intersection B? 1, 7, 13. 1, 7, 13. Intersection of sets means here we are taking the common elements in the two sets. Then that will be called as intersection of sets. So this will be represented in the Venn diagram. Okay. So see here. A having 1, 2, 3, 7, 11, 13. 1, 2, 3, 7, 11, 13. B having 1, 4, 7, 10, 13, 17. 1, 4, 7, 10, 13, 17. Here the common elements are both sets having 1, 7, 13. 1, 7, 13. So these are the common elements. 1, 7, 13. So this is the intersection part for the two sets. Okay, ma? Already these are all I think. But here just we recollect all the introduction part, that is all the sets definitions and what, how to find out union and intersection, how to take the sample space, how to take the events. If we recollect this, then the random variable definition and all the concepts are very easy to do. Okay. So So here, if you are taking events A, comma L, comma R, here we are taking three events A, L, R. Okay, complement. Suppose rule one, complement. Probability of A complement is equal to, how to get the probability of A complement? Already in the previous slide we learned, probability of not occurrence of A is equal to 1 minus probability of occurring of A. Okay, so probability of A complement is equal to 1 minus probability of A. Okay, ma? So next, disjoint events. Disjoint events. How to take the disjoint events means, what is disjoint events? If we are not having any common elements, if the two sets are not having any common elements, then those sets are called disjoint events. Already mana previous chusam kada, two sets lo common elements emi lekapothe aa two sets ni manam disjoint events antamu. Common elements ante enti? Intersection part. Intersection part emi lekapothe, intersection part anedi null set aithe, then those two events are called disjoint events. Okay ma? So here P of L union R equal to, P of L union R equal to P of L plus P of R. Actually here minus P of L intersection R will be there, but intersection part is zero. Why intersection part is zero? Here assuming L and R are disjoint, whenever disjoint the intersection part is zero. That's why minus here no intersection part will be there. Okay, that's why if you are taking disjoint events, then P of L union R is equal to P of L plus P of R only. Okay, so inclusion exclusion principle, this is inclusion and exclusion principle. This is P of L union R is equal to P of L plus P of R minus P of L intersection R. జనరల్ గా ఇది మీరు ఇంటర్మీడియట్ లో ఎలా తీసుకుంటారు, పి ఆఫ్ ఏ యూనియన్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు పి ఆఫ్ ఏ ప్లస్ పి ఆఫ్ బి మైనస్ పి ఆఫ్ ఏ ఇంటర్సెక్షన్ బి. ఓకే, వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద వేరియబుల్స్ విల్ బి చేంజ్ ఓన్లీ. హియర్ వి ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద ఈవెంట్స్ ఎల్ అండ్ ఆర్, దట్స్ వై దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఇన్క్లూజన్ అండ్ ఎక్స్క్లూజన్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ హియర్. ఓకే, సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద వెన్ డయాగ్రామ్స్ ఫర్ దీస్ త్రీ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్. ఓకే, సో సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ దిస్ విల్ బి ఏ, దిస్ ఈస్ టోటలీ set will be there, this is A. So except this A, A complement. Okay, A complement. Next, L union R, no overlap here, no overlap because there is no common elements here, that's why no overlap here. L union R overlap, so whenever overlap compulsory intersection part will be there, that means some of the common elements will be there. Eppudaithe manaki overlap ayindi anukunte అప్పుడు కంపల్సరీ అందులో మనకి కామన్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఉన్నట్టు, అంటే ఇంటర్సెక్షన్ పార్ట్ సమ్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ విల్ బి గెట్టింగ్. ఓకేమా? సో దిస్ ఈస్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద వెన్ డయాగ్రామ్స్ ఫర్ దిస్. నెక్స్ట్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్స్. డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్స్. ఓకే, డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్స్. హియర్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ సెట్ ఆఫ్ ఎనీ టూ సెట్స్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఈస్ the set of the members of set A which is not the members of set B. Okay ma? చూడండి, ఇప్పుడు సపోజ్ మనం టూ సెట్స్ ఏ అండ్ బి తీసుకున్నాము అనుకున్నామా, ద డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్స్ అంటే సో ద సెట్ ఆఫ్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్ ఏ విచ్ ఈస్ నాట్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్ బి. ఓకే, సో సెట్ ఏ లో ఉండాలి, సో అవి సెట్ బి లో ఉండకూడదు అని. ఓకేనా? సో సీ హియర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. So A is taking as 0, 1, 2, 3. A is taking as 0, 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 2, 3. B equal to 2, 3. So if we observe these two sets, here we are doing difference of sets operation. So difference of sets operation, that will be represented as A minus B. A minus B to represent as some. So what is A minus B? A lo, set A lo undali, set B lo undakodadu ani. Okay na, chudandi ikkada. Is the set of elements of set A which is not the elements of set B. And the set A lo undali, avi not the elements in set B. Okay, so ippudu 0 undi, idi B lo ledu. 1 undi, B lo ledu. 2 undi, B lo undi. త్రీ ఉంది, బిలో కూడా ఉంది. సో అంటే ఏంటి ఇక్కడ సెట్ ఏలో ఉండాలి, బిలో ఉండకూడదు అంటే. సో వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ విల్ బి గెటింగ్? జీరో కామా వన్, జీరో కామా వన్. సో ద డిఫరెన్స్ సెట్ ఈస్ జీరో కామా వన్. ఓకే, దిస్ ఈస్ ఇన్ దిస్ వే వి ఆర్ క్యాల్కులేటింగ్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ టూ సెట్స్. ఓకే అమ్మా, నెక్స్ట్ హియర్ సాంపిల్ స్పేస్. వాట్ ఈస్ మెంట్ బై సాంపిల్ స్పేస్? If you are taking any experiment, if you are considering all the possible outcomes in that experiment, then that will be called as sample space. Okay ma, manam oka experiment edaina chesedappudu andulo vachina outcomes annitni manam consider cheskunte, that will be called as sample space. Okay ma, that will be called as sample space. See here, consider a random experiment. The set of all the possible outcomes is called the sample space of the experiment and is usually denoted by S. Okay, so anni possible outcomes ni manam consider chestunte danni manam sample space antamu, danni capital S tho represent chestam. Okay ma, any subset E of the sample space S is called an event. Event means here subset of sample space, that will be. Okay, so here see, tossing a coin experiment, what are the total outcomes? Head and tail. So S equal to H comma T. Okay, suppose if you are taking only head, appudu adu emavutundi? Event avutundi. Anni outcomes ni manam consider chesthe adi sample space avutundi. Only konni outcomes ni manam consider chesthe adi event avutundamma. Okay na, next to tossing a die. Tossing a die. So die means that is having totally six sides. So what are the outcomes will be getting total? So the sample space S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the sample space. Okay, ma. This is the sample space here. Next event. So event means. Mare evaru ala draw chestundi. Event. An event associated with a random experiment is a subset of the sample space. Event ante sample space ki subset ne manam em antamo antama event antam. Okay na, suppose ikkada oka example chudandi, rolling a die experiment. Suppose manam rolling a die chesamo anukondamma, appudu S equal to em avutundi? Sample space. Anni possible outcomes enti ikkada 1 2 3 4 5 6. ఇందులో మనం ఒక ఈవెంట్ ని గెటింగ్, ఈవెంట్ ని గెటింగ్ అండ్ ఈవెన్ నంబర్, దీన్ని మనం ఈవెంట్ గా తీసుకోవచ్చు. ఎందుకని ఇక్కడ చూడండి, గెటింగ్ అండ్ ఈవెన్ నంబర్ అంటే ఇందులో మనకి ఈవెన్ నంబర్స్ ఏమొస్తాయమ్మా? 2, 4, 6. అంటే ఇక్కడ మనం ఓన్లీ కొన్ని అవుట్కమ్స్ ని మాత్రమే తీసుకుంటున్నాము, కాబట్టి ఇదేమవుతుంది? ఈవెంట్ అవుతుంది. అన్ని అవుట్కమ్స్ ని కన్సిడర్ చేస్తే అది శాంపిల్ స్పేస్ అవుతుంది. ఓకేమ్మా, దట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ శాంపిల్ స్పేస్ అండ్ ఈవెంట్. Always the event is the subset of sample space. Okay ma, eppudaina gaani event anedi subset of sample space. Okay na, so these are the axioms of probability, already we know here. So probability means for all the events, probability of event is always in between 0 and 1. Okay, in between 0 and 1. Next the entamma, P of S equal to 1. What is S here? Sample space. What is sample space? All the outcomes. That means probability of all the outcomes is equal to 1. P of S is equal to 1. Okay, ma? So if you are taking for any sequence of events, E1, comma E2 and so on, which are mutually disjoint. Okay? Then we are having P of union N equal to 1 to infinity AN. That means probability of summing, by summing all the probability of events. Okay, union in the sense by taking the summation here. Union is equal to summation of probability of all the events. P of E1 plus P of E2 plus P of E3 and so on. Okay, so here for any event E, we refer to P of E as the probability of E. Okay ma, so these are the three axioms of probability. Okay, next conditional probability. Conditional probability. Okay, so if you are taking, when we are using this conditional probability, suppose if you are having two events, మన దగ్గర టూ ఈవెంట్స్ ఉన్నాయి అనుకున్నామా, అందులో ఒక ఈవెంట్ ఆల్రెడీ మనం నోన్ ఈవెంట్, మనకి ఏం కావాలి అంటే అన్నోన్ ఈవెంట్ యొక్క ప్రాబిలిటీ అనేది కావాలి. సో అప్పుడు మనం ఇన్ దట్ కేస్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ కండిషనల్ ప్రాబిలిటీ. ఓకే అమ్మా, చూడండి, వెన్ వీ వాంట్ ది ప్రాబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ ఈవెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ ఏ కండిషనల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్, ఫ్రమ్ ఏ కండిషనల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్. సో దీన్ని ఎలా రాస్తాం మనం, పి ఆఫ్ బి బై ఏ. What is the meaning here? P of B by A. Remember this. Whatever the event in the denominator, whatever the event in the denominator will be known. Okay? Known. Now, whatever the event in the numerator, we are calculating that probability. Okay? P of B by A ni manam even choltamu antama. The probability of B given A. Okay? Probability of B given A. Whatever the event in denominator, that will be given here. Okay? Probability of B given A. Okay, ma? So here, a probability that takes into account a given condition. And based on some condition. Condition ni base chesukoni manam probability ni consider chesukunte, that will be called as conditional probability. Okay, ma? That will be called as conditional probability. So already here P of B by A equal to P of A and B by P of A. A and B. And means here we are using intersection. Okay. Here we are using intersection. So P of B by A is equal to P of A intersection B by P of A. Okay. So here P of A cannot be equal to 0. Suppose ikkada manaki P of A denominator lo unna P of A anedi 0 avakodadamma. Suppose 0 ayindi ankonde appudu em ostundi manaki result? Anything by 0, that will be infinity. Okay, we are not getting the probability as infinity. Manaki eppudu probability anedi infinity raakodadu. Compulsory manaki a probability teeskuna gaani adi 0 ki 1 ki madhyalo maatrame undalamma. కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ వెన్ ఎవర్ వి ఆర్ టేకింగ్ కండిషనల్ ప్రాబిలిటీ, ఎప్పుడైనా గానీ మనం కండిషనల్ ప్రాబిలిటీ తీసుకున్నప్పుడు పి ఆఫ్ బి బై ఏ, ఇది మనం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవడం కూడా చాలా ఈజీగా గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవచ్చు. వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ఈవెంట్ ఇన్ ద డినామినేటర్, డినామినేటర్ లో ఏదైతే ఈవెంట్ ఉందో అదే ఈవెంట్ ఇక్కడ డినామినేటర్ లో వస్తుంది. ఓకేనా? సో న్యూమరేటర్ కంటెంట్స్ పి ఆఫ్ ఏ ఇంటర్సెక్షన్ బి. ఓకే, సో ఈ డినామినేటర్ లో ఉన్న పి ఆఫ్ ఏ కంపల్సరీ కెనాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0. Suppose equal to 0 అయిందో మనకి ప్రాబిలిటీ ఇన్ఫినిటీ వస్తుంది, దట్ విల్ బి నాట్ గెటింగ్. ఓకే, అలా మనకి రాకూడదు. కాబట్టి ఆల్వేస్ P of A is నాన్ జీరో వాల్యూ. ఓకేమా, సిన్స్ వీ నో దాట్ A హాస్ అక్కర్డ్, A కంపల్సరీ అక్కర్ అయినప్పుడు మాత్రమే మనం ప్రాబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ B ని కండిషనల్ గా క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేస్తాము. సో P of B by A means ప్రాబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ B given A. Probability of B given A. Okay, ma? So this is the conditional probability. Same, either P of A by B anukunnama. So what is the formula? P of A by B. Numerator is same. P of A and B divided by P of B. Okay? So ikkada A event aithe denominator lo undo. A event yokka probability ikkada manaki denominator lo ostundi. In that way you remember easily. Okay? So this is about the conditional probability. Okay, ma? This is about the conditional probability. Okay, ma? Okay, ma'am. Totally 32 members only present here. Okay. So now this independence will be discussed in the next class here. So in this class, what we learn? So first, why the probability concept is introduced? In non-deterministic signals, the probability concept will be introduced. Next, this is a definition of probability. So based on the probability definition, we are taking the probability of not occurrence of A, and next experiment. These are the some of the definitions here, and this is one example set definition. Different types of sets, definitions and examples. Venn diagrams, how to draw the Venn diagram, and sample space, events and axioms of probability and conditional probability. Okay, so in this class we learn all these. Okay, ma'am. So next, independent sets, that will be discussed in the next class. Okay. Okay, two. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.